discuss the lab experimenter, that is 14th experimenter to interfacer 4x4 keyboard into 4x4 keyboard and display the key code on LCD. So before moving to coding part, first we'll see how we have designed the code. So student, this is the 14th experiment. In the 14th experiment, you are going to use one is LCD display, second one is keyboard. You need to interface keyboard to the kit, and when you press the key on that keyboard, that should be displayed, the particular value of the key should be displayed on LCD. So here there are two parts. First part is related to LCD and second one is related to keyboard. So what we did here is we have written the function for keyboard and we are calling that function from this program, that is to display message using LCD. So here you can see we are calling that function. So I have written the function for keyboard and I have converted that function into header file, and I am calling that function. I have included that header file in the library and I am calling that function function keyboard. You can see here the function keyboard from this program. So now before moving into the program, so first we will see what is LCD and what is a keyboard. What is LCD and what is a keyboard, like how the keyboard works. So first one is LCD. LCD is nothing but liquid crystal display. So let me take you to the particular slide. So this is the normal commercial available LCD. LCD is nothing but a liquid crystal display. There are different versions of this LCD screens are available. Those screens are like 16 into 2 LCDs in market available in the different version. Let me write here 16 into 2, 1 minute, 16 into 2, and other versions are 20 into 4, next version is 32 into 8. What do you mean by 16 into 2? 16 means you can display 16 characters and there are 2 lines. That means in this is a 16 into 2 display. Here you can display 16 characters and on 2 lines. That means total you can display 32 characters. Per line you can display 16 characters. 20 into 4 means each line you can display 20 characters and there are 4 lines. 32 into 8 means each line you can display 32 characters and there are 8 lines. And these LCDs are known as alphanumeric LCD because this will not display some like graphic symbols and all. And this cannot be used for graphical representation. So in case for graphical representation, you need to go for TFT graphical LCD screen. So this is a alphanumeric. This will display only alphanumeric characters. Clear? So now this is normal 16 into 2 LCD. 16 into 2. That means you can display 16 characters into 2 lines. Now these are the pin configurations. These are the pin configurations. 1 minute. These are the pin configurations. Like it has got 10 these many pins. So first 3 pins are called as ground, VCC and contrast, and we have 3 more pins are here, RS, RW enable, then data DB0 to DB7, then next one is called as a black light pin, that is LED plus and LED minus. This black light we use normally in the when you use the display in the, during the night time. So these are the pin configurations. I will explain you these pin configurations. So we will go to the pin configuration first. Student, so this is the pin configuration. So here you see we have LPC 2148. So please concentrate, I need to move all these things and all, so please concentrate. So here we have LPC 2148. This is a microcontroller, we know. So this has got 64 pins. Normally 64 pin, it is a quad flat package, 16 pin on each side. Here I have not represented like this, but 16 pins are on each side. Now this is the LCD 2 into 16 LCD panel. So in this panel we have pin number 1 is known as VCC, pin number 2 is ground, pin number 3 is contrast, 4, 5 and 6 are called as command lines. RS, register select, read write, enable. Three pins are called as command lines. This is used to write the command into the LCD. This is not used to write the data, write the command. In order to work, you need to send some commands to LCD in order to work it properly. So these 3 pins are used for that purpose, write the command. Then we have pin number 7 to pin number 14. Pin number 7 to pin number 14 used to pass the data line data. Then we have pin number 15 and 16. This is called a black light. This is used during the night, when you want to use the display during the night times, then we are using these 2 pins. So now in the diagram you can see we have connected command lines RS, RW and enable, like RS, RW and enable to the P0 point, port 0, 9, 10 and 11, port 0, 9, 10 and 11, port 0, 9, 10 and 11, please remember this point, port 0, 9, 10 and 11. So we have connected that to port 0, 9, 10 and 11, and we have connected data lines to port 1, 16 to 23. So you need to remember which pins we are using here to LCD connection. Here we are going to connect LCD as well as keyboard. So you need to remember which pins we are using for LCD and which pins we are using for keyboard. So I will come to that one later, but for timing you remember. So this is connected to port 0.9, port 0.10, port 0.11 and port 1.16 to 1.23. Now we have here read signal, register select, read write and enable. What is the use of this one? This command lines are used to pass the command to the LCD for the proper working of the LCD. So what is that? So we'll see, we'll go to the next page and we'll see here. You see, when read select is 0 and read write is 0 and enable, if you make it active low for some delay, then it works like to write the command to the LCD. It works as a to write the command to the LCD. When register select is 1, read write is 0 and enable is equal to enable goes low, active low for some delay, then you are passing data. You may ask what is data and what is command. I told you command is to some instruction to the LCD to work that in particular manner. I will come to that one. Data is nothing but you want to display. For example, welcome to Canberra Engineering College. You want to display that one. That is the data. Clear? But whether it is data or command, both should go through these lines only. Command should go through this line only. Data should go through this line only. Clear? Yes. LCDs are made by number of crystals, n number of crystals. LCDs are made by n number of crystals actually. So in order to display, particular character, it needs 5 into 7 crystals. For example, in order to display, suppose if I take this square, as a crystal, then to display one character, it needs from here 5 into 7. Yeah, so let me draw here one line from here to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 5 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Totally, it needs 5 into 7 crystals. Totally, it needs 5 into 7 crystals. For example, 5 into 7 means to display one character. 5 into 7 means 35 crystals it needs. So, suppose if you want to write A, then particular crystal, for example, if you want to write A, this, something like this, this characters, these crystals are energized, something like this, and it and A will be displayed. So it is made of a 5 into 7, like for each character, it requires 5 into 7, 35 crystals. Now, so what is the command line? We'll see. What is the command line? Command we are going to transfer into the LCD. So these are the command we are going to transfer into the LCD. What is this command? So let me zoom this one. So if you want to clear, display screen, you need to pass hexacode 1, that is 0x1. If you want to decrement the cursor, like if you want to shift the cursor to the left, 0x4. If you want to increment the cursor, you need to pass the command 0x6. If you want to enable two lines 5 into 7 matrix, if you want to enable, then you two lines, then you have to pass this command 0x38. So if you want to blink the cursor, you need to pass the command 0x0e. Something like this. These are the commands we need to pass into the LCD. Clear, student? So I hope it is understood. So now we will go to FRC details. So in our experiment, based on the kit provided by the vendor, our kit has got 5 FRC connector, FRC1, FRC2, FRC3, FRC2, FRC3, FRC4, FRC5, and we are going to connect LCD to the FRC2. We are going to connect LCD to the FRC5. That means, I told you, we are going to connect LCD to the FRC5 means we are using this pin port 0.8 to port 0.11, port 1.16 to port 1.23. So we are going to use this pin, that is we are using port 1 also and port 0 also. Port 0 is connected with port 0 we have connected command lines. With port 1 we are connected data lines. I told you that one. So what are the numbers, what are the lines we are connected? Like for port 0 we connected port 0.9, 0.10, 0.11 and port 1 16 to 23 we connected for data lines. So now other than that we are using here keyboard also. For keyboard we are using FRC1. What is that FRC, how many pins are there in FRC1? We will see here only. See, in FRC1 we have 10 pins and we are using port 0, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23 to connect to the keyboard. To connect to the 8 lines we are using to connect to the keyboard. That means in our experiment we are using port 0 and port 1. And all you see, I need to connect keyboard. First one is I need to connect keyboard to LPC. And I need to connect LCD. So while connecting LCD, you are sending information to the LCD, either command or data. That means all the ports should be output. And GPIO port only. GPIO, general purpose input output. You need not to go for other functionality. So it is the first function, general. And here also, we are using the first function, but it is input, not output. Here you are using input as port as input. Here you are using, keyboard you are using port as input. For LCD you are using port as a output. Remember this one. So now, we'll go to the next slide. Yeah, this is about LCD. Now I will take you to the keyboard. So I will explain about keyboard, then only I will move to the coding part. Student, try to analyze, understand this one. I will take the class till 2:30. So I will take you to the keyboard slides. That is a keypad actually. So we are going to interface keypad to the 4x4 matrix keypad. So how it looks 4x4 keypad? So we'll see that first one. This is the normal view of the keypad, 4x4 keypad. So it contains 4 rows and 4 columns. 4 rows and 4 columns. So how many lines are here? In the rows you have 4 lines, in the column you have 4 lines. That means you need to connect 8 lines to the microcontroller. That's why I am using port 0. I told you in the last slide, I am connecting a keyboard to the port 0, somewhere 0.16 to 0.23. Why? Because I have got 8 lines. That 8 lines I need to connect it to microcontroller. Clear? Okay. Now we'll go to the second slide. This is a schematic, like this is a diagram and this is a schematic. So there is no interconnection between rows and columns unless and until you press the particular key. Now this is the schematic. Here you can see we have 16 push button switches are arranged in columns and rows. You can see in the matrix form. So we have 4 rows pin, 4 rows connection and 4 columns connection. It goes to the microcontroller. But columns are connected with the resistor to VCC. So initially, since it is connected to VCC, this will become, because of VCC, this will become 1, 1, 1, 1. Because we have connected to VCC. unless and until you press the switch, this value will not change. If you press the switch, then there will be intersection will form. It forms intersection. For example, if I press this switch, then, and for example, I will make, initially I will make this as 0, 0, 0, 0. And if I press this switch, this push button switch, that time there will be a path established. Low resistance path will be established and current moves in this direction. This is the high resistance path and current moves in this direction, and this one is pulled down to zero. So you need to check the column, which column goes zero. So now if this column goes zero, then you will come to know this, that any one of the key in this column is pressed. This may be this key, that may be this key, this key, this key, this key. Any one of the key is pressed. But now to understand which key is pressed, in which row the particular key is pressed, what we have to do is, what we do is here, we will pass, sequentially we will change this value. First we will change this value 1, 0, 0, 0. Suppose if this key is pressed, once again this 1 will blow here and this becomes 1. By that we will come to know which row the key is pressed and which column the key is pressed. So this I have explained in my theory session also. So I will not go into more this one in this regard. So let us move to the next slide. So here you see what we are doing is this internal schematic. First we will assume all these are 1 and 1 and 1 because columns are connected to VCC, and this will make it 0 0 0. When you press any one of the key, then the particular column becomes 0. Particular column becomes 0. So you see here in the next slide. So this so I have pressed the key, this key here, this column become 0. Now you need to find out which row that particular key is pressed. For that, what we do is we sequentially will pass 1 to the each row. For example, first I will pass 1 here. I have pressed this key, so this one has no effect. Next I will make this as 1 and this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. That time I have pressed this key, that's why this 1 will change this column value from 0 to 1. So you will come to know this key has pressed. Now this key has not built-in value. For example, suppose you think you have pressed key 5. This is key 5. But this value is not built in into the key. This is just a push button switch. So you need to make your software to understand by writing the program that particular key value is 5. Suppose if I press this key, the key value is 8. Like that you need to write the code and you need to make the software to interpret that as particular value. So student, so now student, you see here in our experiment what we are doing is, what we do is in our experiment, think this is the microcontroller and this is the keypad, 1, 2, 3, A, 4, 5, 6, some numbers are there. It may not be same whatever keyboard we are using the lab, but I mean we are using 4 into 4 only, but this number may be somewhat differ. So anyway, this is a 4 into 4 matrix keypad and columns are connected like this and row is connected to the microcontroller. Now what we do in our lab experiment to find out the particular key pressed, what we do is, so first we will set the key value, something like this. First we will set the key value, like I will set the column value 0. 1, 1, 1. Then I will make the column value 1, 0, 1, 1. Then I will make the column value 1, 1, 0, 1. And 1, 1, 1, 0. In the cyclic form, I will give this value. What is this value actually? So, for example, first one 0, 1, 1, this is 7. And this one is B. Hexadecimal value is B. This one is D. This one is E. So, I will enter this value. And what I will do is, I will change this value every 50 seconds. Like first I will give 0, 1, 1. Next I will give 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Next every 50 seconds. So that I will change the value continuously every 50, I mean not 50 seconds, 50 microseconds, something like that, or milliseconds, something milliseconds I will change the value. Continuously I will change the value. You will come to know why. So suppose, imagine you have pressed, see normally the rows are connected something like this. Let me draw this one. All the rows are connected with the resistor here. You think like this. All the rows are connected with the resistor. So all the rows are connected with the resistor, and resistor we have given all this is given to VCC or VDD, whatever may be, VCC. That means here the value will be 1111. Here this value will be 1111. And when you press the particular key, for example, if I press this one, this key, then this row becomes 0, because there will be a short and this row will become 0. I mean this row will become 0. So that you will come to know this key is pressed, because you have given the code this one. Suppose you have pressed this key 4. Key number 4, then this key becomes 0. This key becomes 0. If you press 7, this row will become 0. This row will become 0. Now you may ask, sir, if you press 5, when the code is 011, and if you press 5, this will not become 0. Then you may ask, how it will detect the key? That's why, student, I am telling, we will vary this code in 50 millisecond. Normal human touch for the key is takes 1 second to 500 millisecond. 1 second to 500 millisecond, normal human touch for the key. But we are varying this code in such a way, with the delay of 50 millisecond. So that even though when you press this key, that time this code will repeat and this key will get detected. This code will repeat in such a fast, in such a way, in such a cyclic way, and in such a faster way, key will be detected. This is the working principle of this one. This is the working principle of keypad. Clear? So before proceeding, let me ask doubt. So now we will move to the coding part. First we will see the code related to LCD. Then the code related to keyboard. So what is the advantage is, I have written the code related to keyboard as a separate function, and if I want I can call that function in this program. I have converted that as a header file, and I have installed that in key library. I call that header file. And when you call that header file, that particular function also will be called. When you include that particular header file and then when you call that function, that keyboard works. For example, here you see, actually if you here disable this one, then it will not work. See here, I just want to tell you, there are two parts. Like this is the first code for LCD, then second code is for keypad. But this is a function. See, this is the function actually. There is no main in this one. This is a function. What I do is I have written the code and I have converted that into header file and I have included that in library and I am calling that one here by including keyboard.header h and keyboard function. If you disable this one, then on the LCD you will see only department of IEC CEC key pressed, that's all. If you enable this one, then you will see the value of the key pressed. Clear these two things, sir? Now next one is in our program you have included, see one thing, before proceeding I will tell you, you need to connect LCD to the FRC2 and keypad to the FRC1. You know what is FRC2 and FRC1 in our design. So here I have included LPC214X header file. I have included a string.header file. I have included stdio.h header file and I have included keyboard.h in case keyboard is required. So of course we want keyboard in our this one. So I will remove this one while executing the program. I will remove this command. Other than that, I will define the macro, just like macro. I will define some label, LCD_RS, LCD_RW, LCD_enable. So I will define, because in the later stage you can directly assign this label. Instead of assigning the value, you can directly assign this label, because I have defined that one. So what is the value? Value is here, the value is, let me write here, the value is, this is, I will write this one only, 0010. This one is 0100. This one is 1000. So you see this value, 0010. So it is actually, if you see this one, actually this is a pin number, till here it is 7, 8, 9. This is the pin number 9. So we are using a port 0 pin number 9. I told you this is port 0 pin number 10. This is port 0 pin number 11. But this is just a label I have defined. Later I will assign this to the corresponding register. You will come to know. Instead of writing every time 0x00020040, you can directly assign the label. Clear? So that is the one thing you have to remember. Now I have prototype. What is the prototype? LCD_command, LCD_data, then delay, GPIO initialization for LCD, GPIO initialization for LCD. Then I have prototype for LCD string, to write the string. LCD_command is to write the command, LCD_data is to write the data into the LCD, LCD_string is to write the string. Then I have defined here the value. I told command value. What kind of command value I have defined here? You see, the command value I have defined here is, I have taken an array of character type 0x38, 0x0c, 0x06. What is this? See, actually, what is this actually? 38. Let me take you to once again that. See, 0, 38 is, it will enable two lines. And one more we have, what is the one more we have? One more we have is 0c. 0c, you see here, 0c, this one, 0c, display on cursor off. It will enable the display, 0c. And one more we have, 06. What is 06? Increment the cursor, shift the cursor to right. Means, cursor should move to right when it displays the character. So three commands we have taken here. Students, we have taken three commands here. That is there here. After that, in the main, main function. So main function, I have taken one variable of int type. Then I will initialize GPIO init. So we will go first to GPIO init. What is there in the GPIO init? Then I will come back to this one. GPIO init. I am configuring pin select register 0 and 2. You know why it is 0 and 2? Because I am using port 0 and port 1. both I am using port, I am using port 0, initial 0 to 15 pin, and port 1 I am using, I told you for what purpose we are using port 1 also. So what I will do is I will configure pin select register as a general input output, first function only, general input output. Then I will configure port 0 IO0 directory, IO0 register with E. What do you mean by E? I am configuring port 0, listen all of you, port 0.9, 0.10, 0.11, 0.8, it is not there, leave it. I am not using. So this I am configuring as E. E means one is for enable, one is for reset, register select, one is for read write. You know that one. E, I am configuring. But first I am configuring that with the direction. Direction means what I will do, by using one, I will make all these as a output. All these pin as output. Why? You may know. Because I will take you to that previous slide. See, I want to give the signal. I want to give the signal from ear to ear. That's why this port should be output port. Output. That's why I configure here P0.9, 0.10, 0.11 as output. Next, clear. After that, I will clear the value. Clear is to clear the value. Don't get confused with the direction. Direction is to configure the direction. Clear is used to, what I will do is, I will write clear register, once again 111, when you write the clear register 111, it will make all this value, RS is equal to 1, 0, RW is equal to 0, and what is that, enable is equal to 0, it will make all the, this value 0, 0, 0. First you configure the direction, don't confuse. But now you are using this one to make the value 000. Clear? Now, I will take one more register, IO1DIR and IO1Clear. Why you are using IO1DIR and IO1Clear? You see, pin number 16 to 23. What is the use of 16 to 23? You see here, 16 to 23 you are using for data lines. That you have to configure as a output. So, what I will do is here, first I will configure that pin as output by using FF, then I will clear whatever, I just want to make sure there should not be any garbage value, so I will clear all the values. So this is the GPIO init. So let's once again, now I have explained you GPIO init. Now what I will do is, I will pass the this value. Which value? LCD command value. First I will pass the LCD command value. So I have, like here I have shown three values, but you can take four also. Here I have written for loop for four values, but here three values are there, that's okay. So I am going to pass this value by calling one more function, LCD command. So now we have to move to the LCD command. What is there in LCD command function? So let me take you to the LCD command. So this is the LCD command. Try to understand try to concentrate properly. So what I am doing here is, I told you, while in the command, see, when passing command, you need to pass the command through data lines only. But while passing command, you have to set this value, RS is equal to 0. RW is equal to, you have to set this value, RW is equal to 0, and enable signal, you need to set it active low for certain time, certain delay, you need to make it active low. Clear? So you see here, first this value, for example, that value, the value I will take here, this value, what I am talking about, this value, don't get confused, this value, I am passing this value, what I will do is, I will shift by 16 times to the left, so that it will go and sit in that particular pins in IO pin. Clear? I told you the value should be come here actually. Whatever value, that value should come here. You set this RS, RW, that is different. After setting this, this value should come here, then only you can shift it. This pin is 16. So you need to shift that value by 16 times left. Clear? So first my job is IO one pin value left shift by 16. Then what I will do is I will IO 0 clear, I will assign with LCD RS. So what is LCD RS? LCD RS is let's go to the first what we did here. LCD RS, LCD RS is we have enabled like this 200. I mean pin number port 0.9 is port 0.9 is equal to 1. That I am assigning to clear. So I will make that 0. When you assign it to clear, that will be become 0. Similarly, I will clear RW 0. Then I will set, see here, IO set. Yeah, I am not using IO clear because you need to set the enable signal. Active low, you don't worry, active low, you need to set the enable signal. So I will use IO set LCD enable. That time enable signal will go low, don't worry, that is a hardware dependent, don't worry. After that I will call the delay for this time, this much of time, like I will call some delay. After that I will clear IO 0 clear LCD enable. I will clear LCD enable. That time this enable signal will be disabled. So by doing this we are passing the command value to the register, LCD display. Is it clear? Next one is we understood now what is LCD command and this one GPIO initialization. Now LCD string function. What is there in LCD string function? In LCD string function, so I have initialized, two strings are there, department of IEC, CEC and key pressed. And this LCD string function take two value, one is 80 and C0, these are the address actually. These are the address you need to pass as a command. These are the address you need to pass as a command to the LCD to display department of IEC in the first line and to display key pressed in the second line. So this will take to the first line, first column, column, and this will take to this second line, first column, C0. So what is there in the string function? In the string function, you will see string function. Yeah, it will take address and message as a pointer, you know. Then we are using variable count and length of type character. Then I will pass the address to LCD command. You know what is LCD command? What it will do? It will take this value, address, and it will go to the based on the address. It will go to the first line or second line. It will call this function. Just now I explained, it will call this function and it will enable all the RS, RW, RN and all, EN and all, and it will go to the first line based on the address, because the first address what we are passing here is 80. 80 will take you to the first line, C0 will take you to the second line. Clear? Okay. After that, here length, so I am counting the length of the length, I am assigning length with the string length function, like I'll just count how many characters are there in the string length function and assign to that length, assign to the variable length, and then I will pass that one by using for loop. I will pass that one with the LCD data. So I will call LCD data. What is there in the LCD data? Now we will go to the LCD data. So LCD data, you see, once again, as you pass the value, that should be shifted to 16 bit left. Then while you passing the data, RS should be, let me write here, RS should be, student please listen, RS should be 0, RW should be 0. RS is equal to 1, not 0, sorry, 1, while you're writing a data. While writing command, RS should be 0. RW and EN is equal, enable is equal to, once again, this one. That's why here you see IO set I am using, IO set LCD RS. In earlier case, let's go to the earlier case. In the earlier case, you see, where is that earlier case command? What I am doing here? IO 0 clear I am doing. Here I am not doing clear, I am setting that value. You see, setting, because RS should be 1 and clear should be RW should be 0. Then I will call the IO setter, then delay, IO clear and delay. This is inside the LCD. Sorry, LCD data. Is it clear? I hope you understood. Okay. So once again, so now we'll connect, I will see how to connect a keyboard, keypad. So here we have, this is the header file I have created. So here there is no main function, we are just defining you can see a definition of the keyboard function. So here you see, we have defined the macro like O1, O2, O3, O4. O is to assign the column values, and this one to assign the row values. So how it works exactly is, so let me write here this one, first one. This E is correspond to, like, you see, this is actually pin number. See, when you assign this to the particular register, this will be pin number like 4, 8, 12, 16 and 20. So it, 19, it starts from somewhere from 20. So pin number 20 onwards it starts. Okay, so the value of E is 1110, and this one is a D. D is nothing but D is nothing but 1101, and next one is B is nothing but 1011, and this one is 0111. So what I am doing is I will vary the column value continuously every 50 seconds like this. And what about the row value? Row value is, see, this is total, this is 8 bit value. This is 8 bit value actually, this and this. And row value is something like, see, this is a different pin. Here you see, this is 0, this is 4, this is 8, this is 12, this is 16. So this is from pin number 20 to 23, and this is from pin number 16 to 19. So that we are using pin number 16 to 23, rows and columns. So what is this value? This value is once again same, see, you see, but this value is something like 0000 1110 1011 0000 1011 0000 and 0111. Like this we are giving the value for rows and columns. Mainly we will vary the value of the columns and we'll check the rows value. You'll come to know. For that what I did is I have defined the macro here. Clear? I have defined the macro. So now after that what I'm doing here is, here I use one clear function. See, here I am using one clear function. I am defining clear to clear the values of, first I will clear the values of the columns by giving like this. Clear the values of the columns. Before giving this value, I will clear the values of the columns. Then I will call LCD STR from my previous this one. LCD STR, anyway, that function is there, you know that one. Then we have one delay function. And here we have one more function, that is scan. It will scan the key, that is the scan function, and a keyboard function, keyboard. So what is there inside the keyboard? Inside the keyboard, So what I am doing here is I will use four values like this. See, I will use four values, this column values. So I told you O is equal to column. So first I will make the column like this, then I will make the column like this, then I will make the column like this, then I will make the column like this. You can see here, first make the column like this and check whether I1 row key is pressed, or I2 row key is pressed, or I3 row key is pressed, or I4 row key is pressed for this value. If it is so, then interpret that as 0 or 4 or 8 or C. Similarly, make second time once again clear and make IO0 set is equal to O2. Column value change from year to year. And once again, call the scan function. If so, 159D is pressed. Otherwise, next value. If so, 26A is pressed. Otherwise, once again clear and call the next value 4. All these will be repeated in 50 millisecond, so that any one of the key is pressed, you will come to know. Now, what is there in the scan function? Scan function, we have a small function here. Scan function will check. See, scan function will check. Like, suppose if you press, for example, student, I will take you to the one slide here for explanation. Otherwise, it's a bit difficult. Let me take you to the one slide here. So I told you, see, when you give this value here, column value here, what will happen is for example, suppose if you press this key, then this becomes 0. This becomes 0, this becomes 1, 1, 1, right? For 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, that means you will come to know this key is pressed. 0, 1, 1. So read like this, 0, 1, 1. So 0, 1, 1. So you are going to compare whatever value is here is same as what you pass here. For example, so whatever value is here, same like you have passed I1. What is I1 here? You see, what is I1? I1 is this one. I2 is this one. I3 is this one. I1 is this one. So you are comparing that in the scan. Whatever the value is in the pin is equivalent to particular key status. Key status you are going to pass here. I1, I2, I3, I4. Then return 1. You are returning only 1 here. Returning 1. If the particular line is true, then it will return 1 and interpret that as I will erase this one. If the particular line is true, particular this one is true, then it will return 1 and interpret that as particular like 2 or 6 or A or E. That's all. So with this, it will come to know which key is pressed and that key will be displayed. This is small example, like a small function. So with this, we can interface keyboard to the LCD. So here we are using one header file for a keyboard function, and we are calling the keyboard function from LCD. So along with this, you can see the demonstration also. Thank you.
Hello student, today we will see the demonstration of 4x4 keypad matrix to LPC2148 microcontroller kit. So this is the LPC2148 microcontroller kit. Here you can see LPC2148 microcontroller based on ARM7TDMI, and this is the supporting circuits. So we have 4x4 keypad matrix. And when you press this, you need to interface this one to this LPC2148. And when you press any key on this keypad, that particular value of the key should be displayed on LCD. So this is 16x2 LCD panel. That means it has got 2 rows and 16 characters per row. It can display 16 characters per row. So now we will see how to connect this one to the LPC2148 controller. So I am using flat ribbon cable. So in my board, I have FRC2 connector. So I will connect one end of the FRC cable to FRC2 connector, and other end of the cable I will connect it to LCD module. So other end of the cable I will connect it to LCD module. After this, I will use one more FRC cable. This one I will connect it to 10 pin port, and other end of this one goes to FRC1 on the control microcontroller. So now I have connected 4 into 4 keypad as well as LCD panel. So after this I will connect 9 volt display to the board. So this is the 9 volt display, DC display. I will connect it to the board, and I will connect this controller to my PC by using a serial interface cable. So serial inline interface cable. So this is the way you have to connect one end of the cable to the UART interface here, and other end of the cable to the PC. After that, we will switch on the microcontroller. Now we will see the program part. So student, now we will open Keil version 4. This is the Keil version 4 installed on this PC. I will open the software. So Keil is the IDE tool for assembly level programming by using assembly level language as well as embedded C language. So if any project is opened, you need to close the project first. Let me close the project and let me open the new project. So new MicroVision project. So I will give the name LCD. So I will create the folder here on desktop. I will create the folder. Keypad, and I am going to keep the files in this folder. So I will create the project here by name LCD project, and it will pop. Ask me to select the target device. In our case, target device is NXP. So go to NXP and select LPC2148. LPC2148. So this is the detail of this is the configuration details of LPC2148. It is a 32-bit microcontroller with the 512 KB flash ROM. So click on OK. So it will ask to add the startup file, because startup file is required for embedded C. So let me click on this one, S. So it will add, it has created now target, and it has added startup.s. Now let me create the file by clicking on file option here. File option here. And let me copy the program. And now I am going to add the file, which I already written the program in that one. So let me select the file. So I will select the file name is lcd.c. I will select this one and I will add this file. So after that, I am going to add one more header file here. keyboard.h. I have added the header file. So let me open the program. Here you can see this is the program. This is the program for keyboard interface. But in this program you have written code for the LCD display. So we have written separate code for keyboard interface, and that is that we have treated as a header file. You can see here This adder file contains the code for keyboard interface. So once you press any key on the keypad, this program will get executed and the result will be displayed on LCD by means of this program. So I have created an adder file, and the adder file is saved in the particular directory. So you can see here in my computer we have Keel installation. So you need to go to Keel folder. In the Keel folder you need to select ARM. In ARM you need to select RV31. In the RV31 browse into INC folder. In the INC folder you can see here we have so many adder files here. In the INC folder we have kept keyboard.h. you can see this is the adder file we have kept. This is the adder file related to keyboard.h. So what is the use of this adder file? So the use of this adder file is from this program I am calling lcd.c I am calling keyboard function. When I call the keyboard function, particular adder file is referred. So once you copy the code or once you write the code, then after that compile the code. Before compiling the code, go to target and right click on the target option. In the target option, select the device. Device is nothing but LPC2148. Select the LPC2148. Then click on target button. In the target button, enable use microlib option. In the output, enable create X file. In the listing, enable C processor listing. User C++ nothing. So in the linker, enable use memory layout. Once done, click on OK. These are the settings you need to do before creating the EXA file. Once you do the settings, then click on translate button. So when you click on the translate button, it will compile the code, and if any errors, it will pop up the error. In this case, you can see it is zero errors and zero warnings. Now click on build and rebuild. So now it has created the EXA file in the particular folder by name lcdprj. Once the EXA file is created, go to the folder. So this is the project folder. Here you can see the EXA file is created. You know what is EXA file? So X file is nothing but final. It's a binary oriented file which we are going to load into the microcontroller. For loading, you need either hardware debugger or software debugger. So here we have Flashmagic is the utility. Click on Flashmagic utility. In the Flashmagic utility, you need to select the device. So let me repeat, Flashmagic we are using to dump the EXA file into the microcontroller. So in Flashmagic, you need to do certain settings. First, you need to select the device. Device is LPC2148. Then you need to set the COM port. In our case, COM port is 3. So how to get the value of COM port? For that, you need to go to the My Computer, right click, Properties, Device Manager. In the Device Manager, you can see here COM and LPT section. Here you can see we have loaded necessary device driver for this board. Necessary device driver from Silicon Lab has been loaded, and it is connected to COM port 3. That is virtual COM port 3. So in the Flashmagic, you need to select COM port 3. And baud rate, you can select 9600 or 19200 depending on the device. Then interface, it is none because we are using inline system programming. You know what is inline system programming? So you are not using any interface here. We are using just inline system programming and this cable to connect microcontroller to the PC. Other than that, oscillator frequency is 12 MHz. Then select the file. After that, enable these two settings to erase the flash ROM and to verify
after programming, after dumping the code, it will verify, this option will verify the whether the code is dumped properly or not. After this, click on start button. Student, click on start button. When you click on start button, you can see here, it will copy the code. After that, it will verify, and once it is complete, you can see here, finished warning. That means it has transmitted the code from PC to the microcontroller. Now you can see the display here, like we have displayed the Department of ISC, CEC. If I press any key, it will display the key value. So if you press any key, it will display the corresponding value. So you can see this is the key A, or this is the fifth key. Value of the key is 5. This is the value of key is 0. You can see, in this way, you can interface keyboard to the microcontroller. 4 into 4 keyboard to the microcontroller. Thank you for your cooperation.